About the three pillars of sustainability in Myanmar, I would explain with illustration. The environment in Myanmar is inseparably from the monastery and Theravada Buddhism. The data show that Buddhism religion in Myanmar is 87%. However, the trend showed to be declined every year, and the other way, religion, Christian and Muslim tend to increase. It means for now, monastery environment generally still good, but the trend is not good. The social sustainability in Myanmar also still considered as a good, especially referring to quality of life. As we know, our highest quality of life is to attain Nibbana. And the FKL Chitlang Without Hesitated mentioned that not all Burman are Buddhists, and yet all recognize and acknowledge the centrality of Theravada Buddhism,
which is what is really meant by the common identity. View that
to be Burman is to be Buddhist. However, the real problem in sustainability in Myanmar is in economic pillar. The question about Myanmar people who famously very generous, good person, and good devotee of Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha, but why generally they are poor? Is it karma exists? Is the Buddha's teaching really true? Well, Myanmar is poor because the lack of qualified human resources and modern technology. Myanmar advanced in spiritual knowledge but left behind in worldly knowledge. However, the growth economy also have two effects. If grow according the Dhamma, it bring the positive effect. But if away from the Dhamma, have tendency a negative effect. People gain wealth by sneaky business, they pursue hedonistic lifestyle, and they are not supporting, of course, the sasana. In the matter of fact, the first solution for economic sustainability is upgrading human resources and modern technology through the educational technology, which can bring positive effect of economy. However, our monastic school nowadays in this area is only connecting monastic environment and sustainability with the social sustainability. This is why the reason why monastic school need to be modern.